नमस्ते नमस्ते ऑफिसर
Mr. T. Surekaran Chetty, the President of the High Court of Bar Association, Traditional and Traditional General of India, the learned judicial officers, other dignitaries and invitees, the learned members of the Bar, the learned senior counsels, the learned registrars of the High Court, the Director, Telangana State Judicial Academy, the Member Secretary, Telangana State Legal Services Authority, the Secretary, High Court Legal Service Committee, the staff members of the High Court, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I, on my behalf and on behalf of the bench, we wish all of you a very happy Republic Day. At the age of 71, a man is considered to be old. Yet, at the age of 71, a republic is considered to be young. Today we celebrate the 71st year of our constitution. It is not only a time for celebration, but also a time for introspection, and perhaps even for meditation. We must review our past performance, examine our failures, and must reconsider the ways and means of concretizing the constitutional dreams of our founding fathers. Undoubtedly, the Constitution is the roadmap for the nation. It is a dynamic document meant to be adopted and adjusted by each generation. Once Thomas Jefferson was asked a pertinent question: having drafted the Constitution, is it meant only for the generation that had drafted it? And he replied, no, it is meant for each generation to adjust and adopt, to interpret and to implement the way it wants to do so. But simultaneously, its core values, its morality, its basic structure cannot be ignored. We must not only adhere to its manner in the worst of the times, depending on how you see the world around you, but we cannot afford to forget our Constitution. Both as the interpreter and as the guardian of the Constitution, the judiciary plays a pivotal role in the life of the nation. Hence, it is our legal, constitutional, moral duty to answer the intriguing constitutional issues which are being raised and to steer the nation in the direction prescribed by the Constitution itself. Our judicial imagination, I'm sure, will be taxed. Our stamina will be tested. But I'm sure we will all rise to the occasion and confront the challenges. We'll do our duty by our people, but our task can be fulfilled, our goals can be achieved, only if we stand united. And let us remember, united we stand, divided we fall. We do look forward to working for our people, for our state, and indeed for our nation in the next 11 months of this year and many more decades to come. Thank you very much for giving me a patient.